Hello YouTube, welcome back to my channel, and in this video I'll be comparing the OnePlus 2 with the Xperia Z5. Both phones are flagship phones for their respective companies. Obviously the OnePlus 2 for their OnePlus and Xperia Z5 for Sony. Now before I start this comparison guys, I wanted to discuss something extremely important and I wanted to get that out of the way before we get into further details. Both these phones actually share a Snapdragon 810 version 2.1, not the older Snapdragon 810, the newer version, which is the version 2.1. Apparently that version has been throttled down and the frequency of the CPU has been brought down so that the heating issues do not bother the phones or the equipment inside. Now both these phones, like I said, have Snapdragon 810 version 2.1 throttled at lower frequency, hence in my experience so far I've had no heating issues whatsoever. If you're watching this video and you are concerned about the Snapdragon 810 in both the Z5 and the OnePlus 2, I can assure you I've tested these phones for quite a while and both of them had no heating issues whatsoever. What I'll do is I will leave a few links down below in which I actually checked the temperatures by pushing both the phones to the limit. Those videos were actually my gaming videos. So I did game on the OnePlus 2 and also on the Xperia Z5, and they were extended prolonged sessions, and I used my heat gun to keep an eye on the heating side of things, and I'm happy to report that none of these phones have got any excessive heating issues. They go to around 38, 39, 40 degrees Celsius, but that's pretty much average with every phone. Phones like, for instance, the HTC One M9 and the Xperia Z3 Plus, which both had the same Snapdragon 810, had lots of issues. All those people who ended up buying the Xperia Z3 Plus and the M9 had to face a lot of heating issues on both the phones, even though later with OTA updates it improved, but still heating issues persist. Whereas in these two, I'm happy to report, like I said guys, no heating issues whatsoever. You can buy both of these phones with confidence without worrying about any heating issues whatsoever. Now let's jump into further details. We'll be discussing the build quality, obviously the software side, camera side, performance and call quality, speakers, everything, and I will try to cover as much as I can. Okay, so first of all, let's start off things with build quality and the in-hand feel. On the OnePlus 2, as you've seen in several videos and I've shown you quite often, this is the sandstone version that I have got, and it's extremely grippy, and the phone is surrounded by this nice metal frame going all the way across, and this adds a bit of elegance to it. Now this phone is very, very cheap guys. You can get this in the UK and Europe for £289, which is the 64 gig version with 4 gigs of RAM, and the 16 gig version with 3 gigs of RAM is even cheaper, but I would not recommend getting that for a price as cheap as this. I would suggest go for the 64 gig 4 gig version, and this is the variant I'm using here. So the phone is extremely grippy, and because of the metal frame surrounding the phone, I do not feel as if I'm going to lose this phone or drop this phone from my hands, and it will definitely not drop, and even without a case you can easily survive with this phone. This phone also has replaceable back, as you can see. If I just leave this off, I will show you. There we go. If you take the cover off, you have different cases and covers available for the OnePlus 2. The only problem I see with the sandstone version is every time you put your nails across, you can see these marks that come up. This is a bit of a turn off for me. At times it puts me off, but then obviously they always go away. But remember that this is a part of the wear and tear, and if you're going to be using the phone without any case, then most likely in a few months' time, you will have plenty of scratches and marks on the sandstone version. There are many other versions available, the wood version and a few other versions, and I'm sure you can always replace them should you wish, or get another of the same sandstone version should you wish. The phone also has a dual SIMs, by the way, unlike the Z5, which is a single SIM version. There is a dual version available for Z5 in India and in the Far East, which I'm sure you guys can easily get hold of. So in terms of build quality, OnePlus 2 for the price, it's top notch, no issues whatsoever. The phone comes with Type-C USB as well, which is great, and as bottom-facing speaker, which we will test in just a moment with the Xperia Z5. So, in-hand feel and build quality, guys, extremely grippy, very nice, no slippery at all. It's slightly bigger, obviously, but both these phones are big anyway. So, anybody watching this video, obviously, they wouldn't be looking at the video if big phones were not what they were looking for. Okay, looking at the Xperia Z5, the very first thing I want to mention, which I have felt from day one, ever since inside the phone is the way this phone is in hand. It is extremely slippery. And let me emphasize, this is one of the most slippery phones I've ever had, ever since I've started buying phones. So this is, as you know, as this phone, this 5, has a frosted back as compared to the glass back in the previous versions like the Xperia Z3 Plus and the Z3. I had the Xperia Z3 and it had a glass back. So at times when my palm would get sweaty, I was able to hold and have a bit of grip on the Z3. And despite that phone also having the same metal frame as the Xperia Z5, at least the back was glass and my sweat in my palms would allow me a bit of grip, if not much. But because of the frosted back on the Xperia Z5, there's hardly any grip. Even if you got sweat in your hands, it will not stick to the back and this phone will slip out of your hands within no time. So if you're going to be buying this phone, guys, I would suggest please buy a case and you will definitely drop this phone. I'm a very, very careful person when it comes to using smartphones, but I can assure you this is one of the most slippery phones I've ever had. So as soon as you get the phone, in fact, I would say before even ordering the phone, get the case first and then order the phone. So the case arrives before the phone. But otherwise, the phone is brilliant. It has a fingerprint scanner. On the OnePlus 2, by the way, the fingerprint scanner is at the front, as you guys know already. And on the Xperia Z5, for the first time, the fingerprint scanner is actually embedded in the power button, which is extremely convenient because on the OnePlus 2, you have to move your thumb all the way down there just like that to open it up and can be a bit inconvenient at times. And mostly I end up holding the phone in my left hand and then putting a finger or a thumb to unlock the phone. Whereas on the Xperia Z5, it's more natural. So if you're a right-hand person, you just hold your phone like that and then you press the thumb like that and the phone opens up without any issues. By the way, it's very, very accurate, extremely quick, and I think the implementation is a lot better than the one on the OnePlus 2. The fingerprint scanner on the OnePlus 2 is not too bad, but it's not accurate and as fast as the one on Xperia Z5. So I definitely give a thumbs up to Sony for this beautiful implementation. Also, I like the camera button here as well. It's a two-stage camera button, so you press it halfway to focus and then further down to take the picture, which is a very, very handy addition, and very few phones come with this. If you're a shutter bug, if you love to take photos, I think this is the phone probably you should be looking at. The phone also has obviously a 23 megapixel camera, which I will discuss later in the video. So in terms of in-hand feel, build quality, guys, this phone is extremely slippery. It's on the bigger side, obviously. You have to use two hands at times, in fact most of the times, but please make sure that you get a case for this phone or you will definitely drop this phone, no question about it. But all in all, elegantly made, nice metal frame, and the metal frame matches the back of the phone and the whole of the frame, same graphite black color that I've got here, and it also has NFC, unlike the OnePlus 2, which has got no NFC, if that bothers you. So this is definitely a point, another point earned by the Xperia Z5. Okay, now when it comes to screen quality, both phones have full HD 1080p panels. In my usage of both the phone screens are very sharp. They're very bright, and even if I rack the brightness up to full, there are no issues. Even outdoor visibility, when you go out and about, both phones have extremely good screen quality, so you will have no issues whatsoever. In fact, if you rack the brightness all the way up, at times at night time, it can really hurt your eyes. So I would not suggest racking the brightness all the way up, because that's not good for your eyes. I normally keep it around both the phones around 60-70% max. I don't go beyond that because obviously it will affect the battery life as well. So I would suggest keeping the brightness of both the phones around 50-60% if you want to save your eyes. If you want to melt your eyeballs, please feel free to rack the brightness all the way up. But long story short, these are one of the brightest 1080p panels I've seen in 2015, and thumbs up to both companies for producing some high quality screen on both the phones. Okay, now when it comes to performance, like I said, guys, earlier, both phones have a Snapdragon 810 version 2.1, and also this one comes with 4 gigs of RAM, the OnePlus 2, and the Xperia Z5 comes with 3 gigs of RAM. Now, I know there's a difference of 1 gig, but in day-to-day use, gaming, social media, WhatsApp, Facebook, taking photos, both phones had no issues in performance. They are both top-notch performing phones, and I've had no issues. The only minor issue, I would say, is minor, not major. That time when I was using the Xperia Z5, there's a bit of throttling still going on. The phone did heat up once, that is in the last few weeks, only once. And OnePlus 2 hasn't even had not even one scenario like that. But the Z5 did heat up once, and I saw the phone stutter a bit, just a little bit, not much. But ever since then, no issues whatsoever. So I could see there was a bit of throttling going on at the back end. But apart from that, no issues. Even then, after that incident, I really pushed the Xperia Z5, played games on it, used camera on it, but it never ever came to that point where it would start throttling the performance again. So had no issues again there whatsoever. So when it comes to performance, guys, both phones are extremely smooth. They're very, very powerful, and they're very responsive. And one thing is for sure, buying either of these phones, if you're going to be buying them now, you can be assured that for the next couple of years, you will have no problems whatsoever. Both phones are feature proof, and a Snapdragon 810 chipset is a 64-bit chipset, and the next versions to come, more Marshmallows or whatever comes next, they will easily support, and both companies will be sending plenty of OTA updates in the years to come. So performance wise, no issues. Heating wise, no issue. Don't worry about heating about these phones. They are super cool. One of the coolest Snapdragon 810 phones I've had this year. Okay, now when it comes to battery life, guys, this is one area where OnePlus 2 was initially very good, then it struggled after a few OTA updates, and then eventually after the latest Oxygen OS 2.2.0, I'm happy to report that the battery life has gone improved a lot actually, and this is giving me approximately 5 hours of screen on time. Let me have a look and see if I can show you. I took a screenshot I think last night when I was using the phone, and there I did see I took a screenshot, and I wanted to show this, guys, specifically to you so that you know. There we go. This is the one. Yeah, okay. As you can see, guys, here, I used the phone and I took the screenshot at about 5% after using it pretty much all night, and social media, Facebook, everything, and I was able to squeeze out 5 hours and 16 minutes of screen on time, which is simply amazing. Now, when this phone came out, it was even getting close to 6 hours after the first OTA update, but since then, I could never achieve 6 hours again. But like I said, I've been keeping an eye on the OnePlus 2. Those of you who follow me, you know I've been putting up loads of videos on OnePlus 2. After every OTA update, I've been informing you guys about everything, including performance and battery life. And now I can confidently say that the battery life is at a very, very respectable level, and 5 hours of screen time is good for any kind of use, even heavy use, and the phone can last you easily one day. Now when it comes to Xperia Z5, guys, I have done a dedicated video on the Z5 and the OnePlus 2. So what I'll do is I will leave the links down below. So if you are interested in watching a dedicated battery performance videos on both the phones individually with plenty of screen on times, Wi-Fi, 4G, both everything, please follow those links down below and you can have a look on the videos. On the Xperia Z5, it is giving me around 4 to 4.5 hours of screen on time depending on how you use it. I'm actually slightly disappointed, if not much, because on the Xperia Z3 I used to get 5 to 5.5 hours of screen on time, but on the Z5 I'm not getting as much. Whether it's the Snapdragon 810, whether it's the optimizations behind it, I don't know what that is, but the Xperia Z5 is not giving as good a battery life as was the Xperia Z3. But 4 to 4.5 hours, if you're a Sony fan, you can still it can still last your working day. It won't be an issue. But like I said, guys, I'll leave you a link down below and you can have a look at the dedicated video on the battery life on the Xperia Z5. But I think OnePlus 2 is slightly better than the Xperia Z5 when it comes to battery performance. Okay, now when it comes to cameras, guys, this camera has a 23 megapixel sensor inside. So this is the new sensor Sony implemented, and also on the OnePlus 2 it has the 13 megapixel sensor with the old Sony sensor, but still a very good camera for pictures. Good low light performance on both the phones, a very good performance on day-to-day photography as well, and they both can record 4K and both can record 1080p. What I'll do is, guys, I'll leave you links down below for their video performance. I've been testing both these phones. I've uploaded many samples of 1080p on both the phones and also 4K on both the phones on my channel. So I'll leave you links down below so you can be the judge and see how the cameras are like. However, in this quick comparison, we will take a quick photo here and see that how the phones perform. I know it's good to have a look at the links and stuff, and obviously you can follow me on Instagram. There's lots of photos there as well, but I always like to do this, guys, in front of you. Take a quick photo and see how the phone performs. So there we go. This is the Clove Cup, guys, and let's take a quick photo without tapping on the screen. I'm going to allow the camera to autofocus and take the picture There you go. And once more, once more, once more, once more. So the shutter speed has also improved a lot as well, so not too bad. Okay, leaving the phone here aside, let's now pick the Sony Xperia Z5, and with the same shot, same angle, let's take a photo here as well if we can. Okay, on the video mode actually, let me just put it on photo mode, superior auto, there we go. Okay, so without tapping on the screen, I'm gonna take a photo. One, oops, the flash was on, let's take the flash off. We have to be obviously fair in comparison. There we go. So tap, tap. It's not as quick as the OnePlus 2. It's taking a bit of time to save the photo, but still fast enough. Okay, so both the phones are on full brightness. Now let's have a look at the photo quality of both the phones and see how the pictures have come out. By the way, the Sony Xperia Z5 is on a 16 megapixel, not 20. And right now, the OnePlus 2 is on 13 megapixel. So now let's zoom in and see how we can, if we can see clove on the cups here. There we go. All right, guys. As you can see that the clove on the Sony camera is slightly more prominent. It's got a bit more strength to the colors, even though a bit oversaturated. From the way I can see, the cup is definitely not as dark a blue as you can see on the Z5, but the colors are more natural on the OnePlus 2. But when it comes to, I think, zooming in and clarity, let me zoom in further if I can. And also on the OnePlus 2, there we go. So if you have a look at very clear, carefully, I think they are pretty much on par. This is a bit on the lighter color side. The colors on the Z5 are a bit more darker, but from what I can see, I don't have any issue. There's a bit of blurriness. The image on the OnePlus 2 is a little bit blurry when you focus or you zoom in too much. Obviously, it's a 13 megapixel camera, so this is at 16 megapixel at the moment, so the difference is there. Obviously, you can see the Z5 is a bit more clear as compared to the OnePlus 2, but the picture on the OnePlus 2 is more natural, whereas on the Z5 is a bit more oversaturated. But as you can see in both the scenarios, zooming it all the way in, guys, still it's readable. It's more than enough for you to put these pictures on, you know, on social media, Facebook, Instagram. So both cameras have excellent quality, and there's hardly any difference in the quality of the both. Let's have a quick look at the Android on top, and let's also zoom in on the Xperia Z5 too. There you go, guys. As you can see, both are looking absolutely brilliant. Obviously, the image on the Z5 is a bit more sharper as compared to the OnePlus 2, but both very. I can see the small scratches on Andy as well, at the front, just next between the eyes. So both cameras excellent, and honestly, I cannot recommend one over the other. Yes, Xperia Z5 is a bit better than it. Obviously, it has more megapixels, but with the OnePlus 2, if you own this one, you're not missing much, and this phone can proudly compete with the Xperia Z5 with no issues whatsoever. So let's close the cameras and discuss more further things. So both cameras and both phones, guys, are recommended. Both obviously, the OnePlus 2's camera wasn't as good initially, but after the last few OT updates, OnePlus 2 have really improved a lot on their camera, and now the shutter speed, the camera quality is improved and is on par with the flagship phones from this year. Okay, now let's discuss about the speakers and sound quality. This is one area I'm sure lots of people are looking at as well. Both these phones have, well, on the Xperia Z5 you have front-facing speakers, on the OnePlus 2 you have a bottom-firing speaker. I've got a video file here, guys. I'm going to play this for you guys, and I will let you be the judge and decide how the speakers are like on both the phones. Okay, the bottom-firing speaker on the OnePlus 2, guys, and the front-facing speakers on the Xperia Z5. Same file for both the phones. I'm gonna play them, and for a few seconds to give you an idea how the speakers are like on both the phones. Both the phones are on max volume, guys, just to be unfair. So let's start off things with, first of all, with the Sony Xperia Z5. Let me just put them in the camera so you guys can see them clearly. There we go. Okay. Thank you. Okay, from what I can see, obviously the French-speaking speakers are more prominent, they're more clear, and it's easy for you to hear the sound coming out from the speakers. Whereas on the OnePlus 2, the sound is a bit further away from you because obviously the speaker is at the bottom. But from what I can see, I think the OnePlus 2 has got a bit more bass to it if you listen to it very carefully. The sound is obviously more clear on the Z5, but it's a bit more bassy on the OnePlus 2. But all in all, both have decent set of speakers, and OnePlus 2, despite having a bottom-firing speaker, is still very impressive and a good piece of kit for you to enjoy your videos and your music and everything else. Okay, guys, so this is pretty much it. I wanted to compare. Also, the call quality on both the phones is excellent. No issues there whatsoever. The Xperia Z5, by the way, comes with a 32 gig of internal memory, so no issues there as well. With the SD card expandability, whereas on the OnePlus 2, there's no SD card expandability, but then again, you are obviously getting 64 gig one for no price. So guys, this is all in all a quick comparison between the two phones. Like always, guys, any questions, please feel free to ask me in the comment section. If you like my video, like I always, guys, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel as it helps, and I will see you in the next video.